Hi, this is Bilal from Speckle. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Revit connector. Let's get started. I'm assuming you already have Manager for Speckle installed. If you don't, go to the video on the pop-up on the top right corner, I guess, and follow the steps described in there. After you have Manager installed, simply open Manager. How do you do that? You can click on Windows and search for Manager, or you can click on this icon on the taskbar, and click on the Speckle icon, and it'll take you to the Manager. So in here, I will go to connectors, and what was the connector I want to install? It was Revit, right? So I'm going to search for Revit, and it's right here. I can open its page, and this is the latest stable version for the Revit connector. I can install it from here, or there are some beta releases available, like this one, alpha, beta. If you wanna, if you wanna be on the cutting edge of the Revit connector, you can install that version from here. But if you wanna be on the safe side, simply install the latest stable connector. I'm gonna click on that. The first thing it's gonna do is it's gonna download the setup file for that connector. After the download process is done, it's gonna install it. All right, the download process is done. Now it's installing it. And just like that, Revit connector was installed successfully. Let's confirm this. You know, if you have multiple versions of Revit installed, we are gonna be installing it for all the versions. Like, let's say that you have the 22 and 23, which is the case in my device. I have both versions. We're installing it for all of them. So you don't have to, download separate installers for each version. So let's open, for instance, Revit 22. Okay, here we are in Revit 22. I'm going to create a new project with the default architectural template, right? And you should have a new tab called Speckle. I'm going to click on that. And let's open Speckle Revit connector. And now you should end up with this dockable Speckle panel. And I can actually dock it on top of the project browser, right? And here it is. Right here, my project browser, the Speckle connector. Now what I can do is, let me actually draw a maybe like a really simple wall. Let's go to 3D view, and I'm gonna, change its height to level 2, and I'm actually gonna select this, and let's create a new stream. I'm gonna name it random stream. Click on create. It's gonna create a new stream. And I'm going to click on send. It's going to convert these walls and send it to Speckle. Let's view it online. And this is how it looks like in Speckleverse. Just like that, now you have installed the Revit connector, and now you can send your data from Revit into Speckleverse. All right, that was it. And as you can see, it's really easy to install Revit connector. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.